Rejoice, for all things will be righted. The joy candle is lit. As Christians, we are to rejoice, yet many things are happening in our lives that dim our joy, if not completely snuff out the flame. One such joy-dimming circumstance is abuse in relationships. On an average, nearly 20 people per minute are physically abused by an intimate partner in the United States. During 1 year, this equates to more than 10 million women and men. Advent is about the incarnation, God coming to earth in the form of the man to bring salvation. Jesus Christ, fully God, fully man, to bring salvation, yes, eternally, but now to save us from injustice, wrongs, things that bring death into human experience. Yes, the Savior was born, and we are to rejoice. And we rejoice when we see the Savior meet us and save us in this life. Perhaps you're mindful, even now, of an area in your own life where you need salvation. Joy is an incredible gift. The promise of joy that we are reminded of by this candle, that the Savior says, I will meet you in your life circumstances, and as you trust me, as the prophet says, Isaiah, that the wilderness and dry land will once again blossom as we trust Jesus in those areas in our life where wilderness and dry land persist. We will not only experience the process of salvation from whatever that is, but begin to know the joy of the Lord, yes, even in the midst of circumstances that are horrific. You see, new life is possible for everyone. For God so loved the world that God sent his only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. Yes, Jesus is for all people. God has promised salvation, yes, eternally, but even now in this life. Living in the hope that all wrongs will be righted is important. You know, as you've heard me say each week during this series of hope, George Santayana writes, there is no cure for birth and death save to enjoy the interval. Isn't it interesting that in between birth and death, we are to enjoy the interval, which is filled with highs and lows, good things and bad things, wilderness and dry land that God promises will once again blossom. Yes, salvation is eternal in Christ, but it is meant for now. So this is the third Sunday in Advent, and Advent anticipates the fulfillment of joy in your life. Advent calls you to walk in the interval between birth and death with the future and present hope that all things that are bad and wrong and unjust will be righted. That's the promise that God has made to us for life. That's the promise that the joy candle reminds us of. May we rejoice, for all things will be righted, for God has the last word. Amen.